We exist to use the sport of basketball to instill positive values in kids who suffer from some form of disadvantage. A lot of that may be refugee background kids, migrant background children, children living in public housing, and what we've got here today at Helping Hoops Croxton, which is the children with an intellectual disability or special needs.
When we first started, it was one program a week, and then it jumped up to about six programs a week, and unbelievable that using basketball as a vehicle, that people are jumping on board and just having an extremely wonderful time.
We can do it, Ollie!
I like it that it puts smiles on kids' faces. Whether, you know, you're coaching different nationalities, there's special needs, there's disadvantage. When people leave my basketball sessions, they leave with a smile on their face.
Kunick to a right, Cunningham joining into the left, gets it and she splashes the two.
Anyone who they can see on TV or you know, see living the dream, is a really positive role model. And Tegan's put her hand up to say, hey, I'm here, you know, if you guys need some help. And I'm the kind of guy to say, well, yes, we do need help. Let's get you involved, you know, immediately.
Nice shot, buddy.
Any kind of events, it's, hey, Tegan, you know, what are you doing? And usually the answer is, what do you need me to do? You know, so it's been great. You know, you can tell with her the passion is there. She really cares. And, you know, whenever she can find time for us and, you know, help out, she's always, you know, keen to help. It's great for us.
I'm an ambassador for Helping Hoops, so it means I go out sometimes to take my own group, but sometimes I might just come and watch my... Obviously, I try and pop in as much as I can during WNBL. I am fairly busy, so it's a bit harder, but yeah, just try and pop in and always show my face, and obviously spreading the word of what Helping Hoops is about and what they're trying to do, and get more people to feel familiar with the term Helping Hoops.
Go, go, go!
I mean, what's there not to love? Like, if you love a game of basketball, then pretty easy. You're in your forte, you're just naturally helping kids that want to play, and I think that's the beauty of it, is yeah, being able to express basketball in the way that I love it to the kids, and it's very important.
It's been great in particular to get Tegan out to communities where female participation in sport is not as prevalent. Even just sort of sparking that conversation is a really important step, and I think, you know, you never know where that can lead. We're not expecting these kids to then go and, you know, become professional, but it's just the fact that, well, girls play too, and no matter where you're from, what your cultural background is, you know, you have an opportunity with Helping Hoops to participate. I think that's a really, you know, positive from our point of view.
Take it down low. Best team can sit down and keep it going. Keep it going.
Mostly we use basketball as a, you know, making good choices, getting better education, building confidence. I've had some shy kids who wouldn't say a word for 3 months, and all of a sudden now they're running around and interacting with the other kids, and they know each other's names. So the friendship has gotten better. Recently, out of a suburb called Richmond, when I first got out there, everyone lined up, the kids were kicking each other, hitting, I'm here, swear words. These are small kids. I'm just going, wow, this is gonna be tough. But, you know, having fun and channeling that energy into sports has kind of just broken down a lot of barriers, and now they're all getting along and it's going great. And we got more girls participating in Richmond than boys, so it's super.
Go as high as you can, touch the wall, and I'll record that number. It's going well.
I don't know how he does it sometimes. He is the most motivating person I think I've ever worked with.
Look, Dan. Hurry! Hurry!
Just making kids stronger, whether it's physical, mental, getting them to make proper choices and stuff. If I can do that with my craft in basketball, that's where the energy and the enthusiasm comes from.
One, two, three!
They're great. Like, every group's different as well, so that's another important fact, that you meet new kids every week, but there's some good ones.
You tear up sometimes about the type of mentor you become and the leadership things that you've instilled in the kids, and when they express it back to you how you've helped them that much, it's just absolutely unbelievable.
At the end of the day, we're not trying to produce for next LeBron James or Kobe Bryant. We're trying to make these kids the best people they can be, and look, have a lot of fun in the meantime as well.
it's good to give back. I think that's really important, being able to express the way I love basketball to the kids and just give them something, whether it's a shooting technique or a drill or anything. It's just important to give back to what I've learned over the years, and if I can do that to one kid, then that's, yeah, it's pretty special.